Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to A Road Retraveled. Let's go! Historically a hamlet on the outskirts of New York City, Greenwich Village is surrounded by Soho, East Village, and Chelsea. Greenwich Village, or simply The Village, has been known since the 1950s to be a significant hotspot for bohemian culture and a center for new movements and ideas attractive to musicians, poets, writers, artists, and students, who are also known as beatniks. Due to the extraordinary increases in housing costs, the bohemian days of Greenwich Village are long gone, with much of its colorful and creative residents having moved on to Soho or Brooklyn. But it's not uncommon to see celebrities nowadays who also call the Village their home. In spite of all the changes over time, The Village still holds on strongly to its culturally unique bohemian, laid-back, and live-and-let-live attitudes that you're so famous for. You know, I wonder what it was like to be here in the 60s. So let's find out. Let's go back a few decades and see what The Village was all about in those days. And then, back to present, we'll go on a short guided tour through the streets of the Village with Rob, a local New Yorker with lots to say about this place.
In the shadows of modern Manhattan, surrounded by glass and steel, yet only a subway stop away from the seething city, with its crowds of people, hectic workday schedules, and the office routine, lies the sleepy village called Greenwich. Village life is cosmopolitan, yet relaxed and carefree. Pleasure is found in just being alive. Suburban living on an urban landscape. A time to pursue personal pleasures, to find self-expression in comfortable clothing. The tempo is leisurely, and cotton's casual appeal is in step with carefree living. Or shopping in the world-famous Bleecker Street Market, alive with the carnival colors of old-world piazzas. With the chores complete, it's time for a few relaxing moments in one of the many popular sidewalk cafes. Night falls, creating a world of contradiction, of paradoxes in life. The tourist is lured by a sense of adventure in losing himself in a modern casbah, while the resident prefers an evening spent at a theater off Broadway, where the actors and audience share their common experiences after each performance. Or an early dinner in a favorite hideaway. Like any other small community, Greenwich Village has its town square, once a field for bloody Indian battles and aristocratic duels, hangings and potter's burials. Washington Square is now an Island Retreat. Here on Sundays, villagers gather for idle pleasure. High above this pastoral setting is the American Arc de Triomphe, perpetuating in stone the ideals of the father of our country. The Washington Arch stands as a monument for all free men. In the old row houses just north of the square lived the 19th century aristocracy. Behind these ancient gates, in leather-bound libraries and French-style drawing rooms, life was gay and frivolous. Greenwich Village is endowed with a great sense of history. Its brownstones, its garrets, cellars, and courtyards have been home to literary masters such as Mark Twain, Herman Melville, and Edna St. Vincent Millay, Washington Irving, Edgar Allan Poe, and O. Henry. Of President Monroe, Patriot Alexander Hamilton, inventors Thomas Edison, Robert Fulton, and Samuel Morse, artists Thomas Hart Benton and Winslow Homer, and others who have contributed to the American heritage. Today, Greenwich Village is the postmark for many countrified cosmopolitans.